Hi folks, today we are going to discuss low-level hemolysis and how it can affect your health. But first let me introduce myself and invite you to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and leave me a comment. I do my very best to answer all questions and read all of the comments, especially those about how I can improve my videos and what you would like me to talk about in the future. My name is Dale Baker, and I am the author of a website, two books, brochures, newsletter, and forum all about G6PDD and how you can stay healthy and avoid complications of G6PDD. Okay, let's get started. Most doctors and others who talk about G6PDD only discuss a crisis and ignore one of the most dangerous problems that can plague people with G6PDD. It can be life-threatening and can destroy your health and your life. And it is very hard to detect. In fact, most people never know it is happening. It is called low-level hemolysis, and it is caused by our body's reaction to triggers. Low-level hemolysis is a demon you really don't want to underestimate. Let me explain. When a baby with G6PDD is born, its body has not learned to adjust to hemolysis. Its liver is not mature and has a problem eliminating bilirubin. So its body is trying to cope with a low red blood count and a high bilirubin count, both of which can be life-threatening. The baby's body takes time to learn to make more RBCs than a normal baby. Within a couple of years, its body will learn and develop the ability to pretty much keep up with most hemolysis demands, if its body has the resources in the form of B vitamins, etc., to do so. Its liver will become mature enough to handle the elevated bilirubin. Things will become normal for the child, unless something unusual happens. The child becomes sick or ingests a trigger that causes more hemolysis than this body has the ability to compensate for. The child will become anemic, or in most cases, just have to make more RBCs. Here's the problem. The more triggers the child or adult is exposed to, the more RBCs the body has to make. The body is at the limit of its ability to make red blood cells already. When it is exposed to another trigger, it is in trouble. Sometimes a crisis ensues, or the body has to make more RBCs than usual. This is called low-level hemolysis. But blood tests do not always tell the complete story. It is quite common for a CBC to show normal RBC and hemoglobin counts in a person who is undergoing low-level hemolysis. The doctor tells the patient that all is well, but in fact, the opposite is true. How long do you think a person can keep overproducing RBCs with impunity? It takes more than a normal amount of resources to do this, and it puts an abnormal amount of strain on the body's organs. The spleen can become overworked and have to be removed. The heart is overworked. Liver, renal, etc. all are overworked and overstressed. Eventually, something has to give. Most of the time this happens in midlife, though it can manifest earlier. Many times the patient is labeled as a hypochondriac, or perhaps misdiagnosed with a health condition that requires a medication that is contraindicated for those with G6PDD. The treatment makes matters worse. If the patient is very lucky, an astute doctor will discover the patient has G6PDD, if the patient doesn't already know. According to a doctor in India, many older people die needlessly due to ignorance about G6PDD. And the sad truth of the matter is, as so do infants. If I sound harsh, I'm sorry. I have heard way too many horror stories. It is vital to your and your loved one's health that you know and understand the truth about G6PDD. Don't play with fire. It isn't worth the consequences, as one doctor I am aware of found out the hard way. Unfortunately, he found out too late to save himself. I don't mean to scare you, but you do have the right to know the truth. So what can you do about low-level hemolysis? Very simple, actually. Avoid all of the triggers on my avoid list. At first, it may seem overwhelming, but as you get to know what to avoid and how to substitute safe foods for those that are not safe, it gets a lot easier. I even have over 400 safe recipes to help teach you what you can eat and how good safe foods can be. All available from my website and the literature available there. So that is my discussion about low-level hemolysis. I really hope you take this to heart and follow my avoid list religiously. I don't want to hear another horror story. Teach your children what to avoid and why they need to avoid them. Please don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and leave me a comment. Tell me what you would like me to talk about in future videos and how I can improve them. Did this video help you understand more about G6PDD? Let me know. You will find helpful links to my avoid list in the comments below. Please follow them and what other lists you may find on the internet and elsewhere. You will also find links to my website, books, and other literature to help you learn about G6PDD. Also, check out my other videos. Thank you for watching. See you next time.